Agent, we have a report of some Rikers on the rampage. I don't want to inconvenience you in any way at all, because you are a very important person. But if you could shut that down, that would just be so impressive.
Listen up, New York. Rick Velasquez here once again with Wouldn't You Know It, the city's premier source for whatever it is I can come up with in between scrounging for food and trying not to get my ass shot in the streets. You want better? You're welcome to go and try and find it. In the meantime, I'm what you got. Now that we've got that settled, let's take a minute to talk about a topic near and dear to my heart. My love. Really, what I'm putting in there, or I ain't, which is to say, cigarettes.
You did that in record time. Not that there was ever a question in my mind. I mean, you wake up in the morning and just think how cool it is that you're you? Over and out.
I got dudes. Oh, who's that? Nope, just a guy. Alright. Here we go. Alright, let's go. Stop. Till I figure out what's going on. Thank you.
We just made a friend for life.
Terrifying. Now I need to get the hell out of here.
Agent, you don't need me to tell you how amazing you are, but as long as we're on the radio,
amazing!
Amazing. You're totally my idol.
I didn't say yes, I said that.
Maybe we can add one this whole thing blows over.
I don't know, dude. You're a little strange. We'll see. You know.
Data scanned. Downloading files.
We've gotten some detention and incriminating evidence and some big corporate negligence. And a suggestion that someone was closer to a cure than we thought. But we need to find the person that evidence came from. And we're looking for a possible whistleblower, a Vexix employee named Judy Walters. Her last known location was Vexix HQ.
Warning. You are now leaving the safe area. Readings indicate an echo nearby.
Listen to me. I don't care what the Andersons told you.
Hey, watch this, asshole!
No, not you. Just get the kids packed, and don't forget Melissa's medicine. We're getting out of the city.
Sorry, sir, I'm gonna have to ask you to move.
We're just trying to dry off. Give us a break.
Okay, I'm sorry, but you'll have to take your things and vacate the area. This is private property and you're obstructing traffic here, man.
Come on!
They're not monsters, Mr. Velassi. I'm going to try and persuade them again.
This is a story whether you persuade them or not.
Listen, you don't have to go in here with it, but
if you can at least get me some kind of
proof.
I need to go. I'll call you back.
active echo beacon detected.
You're an active echo beacon.
Hang on. Mr. Velassi, I meant it. I'm not talking until I give them another chance to do the right thing.
And I hope you'll convince them. But if you don't, I'll be waiting outside to get you out. I'm live on the air at 7.
Judy, they want you in the boardroom.
God, it's getting crazy out there. You know, I thought of taking the day off and calling in sick. My throat's a bit sore. Well, the compensation issue's coming up.
Hey, Judy.
Hey, Judy.
Judy?
Judy?
Readings indicate an echo nearby.
Don't you mean an echo nearby? An echo nearby?
Where are you going?
You know, some more manpower and resources, we'd have that cure. Guess I thought that maybe, just maybe, we'd put humanity first.
And by humanity, I hope she means profits. Am I right, fellow executives?
Okay.
We could do right now. It's a treat symptoms. It's better for everyone.
Let me out. We are not a charity. I hear they're close to a cure anyway.
So you're willing to let people die because it's not in your job description.
Oh, fuck you, Alan. I have kids. But I'm thinking about their future after this thing blows over.
The point stands, we don't have a cure, and we've got to look after our shareholders. The profit we accrue can go towards researching a cure.
That's exactly my point.
Harumph, harumph, money! Yes! If I wanted to help people, I wouldn't have gone into the pharmaceutical and medical career. I wanted to make money, by God! Away, back it up, or is it over here? Yep, this way. Down the stairs, yeah? Right, mate. It's like some Minority Report and shit.
Miss Walters, need you to wait.
Go with me!
Go with me, don't touch me! My name is Judy Walters, don't touch me! Oh! Hey! Oh! Don't touch me! Oh! Hey! Social distancing! Don't touch me!
What the hell's going on over there?
Readings indicate an echo nearby.
Mike Wallace. From 60 Minutes of years ago. That's how the deep state gets you. They disguise your murder as a car crash or a heart attack. Or they download some kiddie, you know what, on your computer.
No, I'm not kidding. It literally just happened right in front of me.
Solano, eh? Person of the Sun? The Deep State Dark Second Sun, perhaps?